In the year 1976, the Indian government passed the iconic Bonded Labour System Abolition Act, making the act of bonded labour a crime punishable by law. But this criminal act still lurks in the shadows.
At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom. A moment comes, which comes but rarely in history, when we step out from the old to the new, when an age ends, and when the soul of a nation, long suppressed, finds utterance. It is fitting that at this solemn moment we take the pledge of dedication to the service of India and her people and to the still larger cause of humanity.
Bonded labor as a term has been completely misunderstood by many. It is not a labor issue. It's actually a human rights violation where you extinguish yourself of all your rights, where somebody else owns you, dictates and decides who it is that you can be and what it is that you can do and for how long you can serve. You lose your fundamental rights. I mean, we have seen cases where children are beaten up because they cry out for milk, because the mothers have to go back and work. A situation where you're not even allowed to grieve. You lost a baby, you still have to go back to the paddy fields. Situations where you have to deliver the baby within the confines of a facility all by yourself. You have no doctor, you're not permitted to go out. You're working till the very last minute when you actually have to deliver the baby. You can only imagine what tools they would have used to cut the umbilical cord. Absolute lack of facilities, absolute lack of just humanity. And there's nobody to question.
Four people have been arrested in Orissa for allegedly chopping off the hands of two migrant workers in the state's Bolangir district. That's according to the police. A local labour contractor paid about 14,000 rupees each in advance to 12 workers for some labour work in Hyderabad. But instead of taking them to the promised destination, the workers were being taken to Raipur to work at a brick kiln. The workers refused to work here in Raipur and 10 of the 12 fled. A furious contractor then ordered his henchmen to chop off the right hands of the two remaining workers.
The violence experienced by Dayalu and Nilambar was brutal. And unfortunately, there are several crimes of this nature experienced by those trapped in bondage that are unfortunately the same.
A huge cycle of exploitation where laborers were trafficked from all across the country, were made to work in multiple facilities with no recollection as to where they were working. In fact, one of them said that in the night time they would be piled into a vehicle and sent to another facility. So they wouldn't know the route, they wouldn't know where they were going. There was no means of communication because all their mobile phones and their identification cards were taken away. And I remember carrying two bags full of their voter IDs and identification cards, ration cards, even mobile phones and SIM cards that were there, which were taken away and kept with the middlemen.
The level of impunity is unbelievably high. Now, you're looking at owners who have believed for generations that they actually own these human beings, that they can do anything that they want to with these people, and he can still get away with it. He has been getting away with it. And suddenly, when somebody comes and challenges you, you can just imagine what the response would be.
In 2005, IJM, along with a group of government officials, initiated a rescue operation in a brick kiln where they had received information that 333 laborers were suffering under an abusive system of bonded labor. The incidents that follow are what happened on the day of the rescue.
When we reached the brick kiln, we saw the laborers working there, men, women and children, all of them working. The owner and his supervisors treated these victims as a human property. They were commodified and they were willing to go to any extent to retain these laborers. The owners and his men, they were angry and they were intimidating the laborers and our team. There was a point when they started manhandling us, so we realized it was getting out of control. We all got into the vehicle and we were about to leave when they stopped our cars.
After a few hours, the team was finally able to escape with their lives alone. The owners saw these laborers as their property, and no one, not even the law, could take their property away from them. They were willing to resort to any form of intimidation, including violence, to hold on to what they believed was theirs.
It is a hidden crime. It is a crime that's not easily detected unless authorities and individuals actually go out and make an attempt to find out the reality of the situation.
Over the past few years, proactive government officials have been making an intentional effort to seek out those who have been oppressed by the bonded labor system. Officials are now coming forward to participate in various training sessions that will equip them to fight this heinous crime. Empowered officials are initiating and leading massive rescue operations, releasing hundreds of bonded laborers across the country.
In one case alone, in 2015, sub-collector of Tiruvallur district, Tamil Nadu, rescued 333 people from a single brick kiln. The district administration worked really hard to provide instant relief. They collaborated with various departments and state agencies to ensure holistic care for the victims. This case set a high precedence nationally. It also sent a strong warning message to all bonded labor offenders.
The Indian law promises freedom and equality to every citizen in the country. Today, there are many bonded labor survivors who are inheriting this promise, creating a ray of hope for those who are still waiting for freedom. A hope that the government will come to their rescue, that they are protected by the law, that they have access to food and water, a roof over their heads, and education for their kids. A hope that the system will defeat this evil. Hope that they can lead lives of freedom.